I got a challenge today that I'm on my way right now to go check out. We got a call 2 weeks ago where we're doing a, this is a condo. And when you think about most people around the country, when they're thinking about condos, you know, they're thinking about, you know, low-end condos, apartments. These things are luxury high-rises, you know, $500,000 to, you know, $2-3 million bucks. And they have a situation in the bathroom where they had drain fly larvae coming out. So we went in and, you know, this is a major process to do this. I mean, we have to send a certificate of insurance to the association that shows our workman's comp, our insurance, prior to being allowed to do this service. We have to charge the client an extra $100 to do that, because for the paperwork to do one individual unit in a condo is going to be extraordinary. So we charge the client extra for doing that work when they call us because they can afford it. I mean, the maintenance fee on this condo is probably more than most people's mortgage, somewhere between $16,000 to $2,000 a month, just a maintenance fee on the condo. It is an expensive place. So we went in and we did a drain treatment, but the tech says, I don't see any flies. I just see the larvae. So I said, that's weird. And it's around the bathroom, the tub. So we said, okay, well, treat all the drains. We use DSV, Nibor D, and Profoam for all of our drain treatments. And then plus, if we have flies, we're going to install a fly lamp in that bathroom to catch all the adults, to stop them from breathing, from breeding. And that's how we reduce it. So what I did was, he went in and the lady said, well, I haven't seen any more since you did the last service. So we do a follow-up service in a week automatically. All of a sudden, we get a call that says, hey, I'm seeing them again. And they're coming out of what appears to be the grout in the wall. So we already knew that they were around that area. I said, all the cracks, you know, pressurize the foam, try to stick it in there in case there's, you know, the grout has loosened up and there's water behind that tile. We'll get the DSV back there. We'll get the Nibor D. We'll kill the larvae. We'll kill the eggs. It works as an IGR, you know, an effect of an IGR, and it will be done with that. Well, get a call this morning. Hey, we're still seeing those worms. But there's no flies. We're not seeing any flies at all. This is a mystery. And here is the challenge that we find ourselves in. And we're talking to associations, when we're talking to HOAs. An HOA in an apartment is different, because in a condo, the owner of the condo owns the interior walls. It's just a legal description. And they own the interior walls. But the condo owns all the common areas in the exterior walls, and that's why you have to pay the maintenance fee to maintain all those common areas. When you hire a pest control company in the building, we go in all the time and see all kinds of problems. They're just baseboard spraying the entire building. I mean, they're selling these 38-floor high-rises for $400 a month. I mean, there's not much you can do. There's so much work. You have to inspect those elevator shafts for water. We get water in those elevators. You're going to get larvae in there. You're going to get mosquitoes breeding in elevator shafts. You got to treat garbage chutes all the way from the top floor all the way down. They don't do that. We find all the time larvae, silverfish, roaches, flies in the garbage chutes 30 stories up. And the customers, I don't understand how these roaches are getting in my house. These are million-dollar apartments. These people have made service. They don't understand why they're having a problem. What they fail to understand, what the HOA fails to understand, and what the customer doesn't understand, they're both ignorant of pest control biology. And this is a major problem. This is why you see me saying, I have to do these shows. I have to show people why the problem exists and why they're ignoring it. See, the problem that you have is that they're doing the common areas. They're not even doing that right. And they're not, they're just going in and spraying, going for the, they sold the cheapest service. The HOA was tickled to death because they thought they got the best, because everybody does the same thing. You know, in the HOA's minds, I speak to boards all the time of HOAs, and they're not getting the insect biology part. They don't understand it, that it isn't about spraying, that the control is the pest control technician. The quality of that technician and the how much time he's allowed to spend on that property. When you're doing 38 floors, you know, stories high, where there is 300-400 units, and you're treating the baseboards only. You're doing a baseboard spray along all the hallways. You're treating the garbage chute, you know, the garbage room, but you're not treating the garbage chutes. Why? Because that could take 4 or 5 hours to really treat that building. A technician needs to be in there 4 to 5 hours, and they're giving them 1 to 2 hours. So he's going with a B&G all over the place, spraying everything, and they're wondering why they got silverfish in the building. I remember one luxury condo that I did a year back, which we spent 6 months trying to control. And this is a place that has marble floors, immaculate. You could not find a dust anywhere in this unit. It isn't about being dirty. We think about hygiene. Well, where were they coming? We had to take and open up every single outlet, every ceiling outlet, every wall void. To top it off, they had, it's a luxury apartment, they had pocket doors, which they're in the structure. So they were having a major silverfish problem in the building, and this person was paying for it. And, you know, you're talking about people who have their air conditioning on all the time. The humidity wasn't that high. And it took us 6 months to get it under control for them, because we couldn't ID the point source in that building. We went into the garbage chute and found silverfish all over the place in the garbage chutes. Understand that there's a garbage chute and there's 3 units. And the garbage chute, 4 units, 5 units, and the garbage chute is right down the hall. We found silverfish in the hallway. We found silverfish all over the dumpster area. We found silverfishes in around the area of where the garbage chute was. They weren't treating any of this. This is the problem, where a company sends the lowest level technician because they put them on top of that, he's going to have probably 5-15 more stops to do that day. And everything is sold additional because they sold a minimum service. And everything is additional. Now, if you want a service done that's special, like a garbage chute service, which should have been included, when you do a building, you should include all the common areas. You should include the garbage chutes. If it has garbage chutes going down, it should be including rodents protection. It should include inspecting all of that and treating that whole garbage room every time. And on top of that, if nobody is pressure cleaning at least those garbage chutes once a year, or every 6 months, that's why we do the DSV. We do the NIBRD. We do the foam on every garbage chute that we take on a building. So when we do a building, we're quoting out $1,200, $1,600 a month, while all these companies out there are quoting $400 for a luxury high rise. This is the problem, that you're buying $1 million apartments and you're not willing as an HOA to spend the right amount of money. Here's the second challenge. Each individual owner has to do their own pest control, because when in a condo HOA, the company doing it, and we just took over a building and we said, you know, we're going to do it. We cleaned it out. It took us 6 months to clean out this building. Okay. And then after we cleaned up this building for 6 months, we found that where the point source was, it was the garbage chute, that all the roaches were in that first floor laundry room. And then it was another point source, because we used a report to be able to monitor everything. We inspected every unit. We sold them a service that cost them $10,000 for us to go in 120 units, inspect all the units, treat all the units, and put monitors in all the units to get them to find out where the point sources were, because these were individual owners. They agreed to pay for it. We converted them to eco-friendly. We converted them to IPM. Then they changed the board. New president came in, changed everything. They changed management company. So now they're saying, well, we're no longer going to pay for the services in the units because we don't have the budget for that this year. Now the unit owners have to pay for the pest control themselves. So now we're getting calls from all these owners going, hey, I need you to come in and do my pest control. Well, now we have to bill you for it. We were billing them, and it was very convenient to. And then we got it down to where this was a 122-unit building. We figured out where the corridor was of up and down from like the first floor all the way up, and we found the point source of the unit that was really heavily infested, and all of the units above and down and on the sides were getting infested, but the rest of the building was clean. And we showed them, hey, look, once we get all this clean, it took us this long to find out, because we had to inspect every unit to figure out where that point source was in 120 units. And then we mapped it and we showed, look, it's 509 and 406 and it's directly above and it's basically on five floors. And we had that work is expensive to do. What they wanted originally, what they were having, all these units were infested. The garbage room was infested. The laundry room was infested. And they had a company spraying baseboards every month. And the guy couldn't do anything more. And he was charging them like $240. And the reason I got this contract is because one of my customers is on the board. Well, she quit. She says, it's not worth being on a board of an HOA, all that stress, all those problems, nobody's ever happy, and you're doing it for free. And I get it. And I do a lot of presentations to HOAs. So here I am. We figured it out. Now I got them to where they're only treating those two units because there's still a problem. Something the customer is doing, the tenant is doing. On top of that, the tenant is renting. So what happens is with the tenant renting, there the owner doesn't want to pay for the pest control because he says, no, it's in the lease that they have to pay for it. They're saying, I'm a renter. I don't want to pay for it. I'm going to fog everything. I'm going to bomb it. I'm going to do everything. And now they're making it. This is how they made it worse for everybody else because people don't understand roach biology. They don't understand how this is how a roach problem from one person moving in to an owned unit and that then saying, I don't want to tell the owner anything. I'm going to bomb it myself because he doesn't want to pay for it. And then I'm not going to pay for it. And now he just spread those roaches to everybody else. And now everybody's paying for it. And understanding HOA owners that bugs don't read contracts. They don't care about your legality of how you're structured. So in an HOA, you need to have really the same company available to say, listen, when you have a pest problem, you call this company. Yes, we're going to pay for it, or you have to pay it yourself. We can do it at a reduced rate once we're there because then we don't have to make a special trip. We're there every month. We can schedule all those units every month. We had it down to where there was only two complaints a month out of 120 units, two complaints. And what they were paying was like $40 to $80 for maintenance, for us to go in for 15 minutes and check it, rebate, check everything, and monitor it and come back the next month. And every time we come back, it's per unit fee. They say, no, we can't afford an extra $40. We can't afford an extra $80. Now we're getting calls and we're having these conversations with the owners. We're having conversations with the tenants. They're not willing to pay for it. I'm talking to the board and the property manager now. Again, says, listen, you're going to end up with a serious infestation. Remember, it costs you 10 grand to fix this problem. And for $80, you're literally straining the camel and swallowing the gnat here, or straining the gnat and swallowing the camel. You're splitting hairs and you're going to get into a situation where then I'm not going to be able, and then you're going to come back on me and say, well, you let it get out of hand. You didn't control it. How can I? They're not willing to let me in. They're not willing to pay for it. You're not willing to pay for it. How do we solve this problem? These are the challenges that we're faced with in pest control, the reality of what a pest control company is faced with, the reality of what we have to deal with, because the board changes every year. Now I have to spend my time as an owner, as a salesperson, as an educator, educating an entire board on insect biology. What is going to happen when they got a bed bug problem and it spreads to that building and nobody wants to pay for it? This is what happens. Forget about slumlords and forget about, you know, people that don't want to take care at all of anything. How are you going to handle HOA, a bed bug infestation, that you're saying it's not your problem, it's the owner's problem? The owner's saying, well, it's the tenant's problem. And everybody's pointing the finger and pointing blame. Nobody's taking responsibility. When this could be easily solved, you get one pest control company, you do the common areas. They're responsible if somebody gets a complaint because you got one company that has care, custody, and control. When you have five companies going in there and everybody's doing something different, when the guy decides to spray pyrethroids on a floor and the other guy on the other unit next door is getting the roaches and he's getting a call and he decides, hell with this, I'm going to spray fipronil, which is illegal because he can't control that problem for his client. And you've got all these guys battling it out. And now the HOA is not responsible. The owner's not responsible. The apartment guy is not responsible. And the pest control company is not responsible. Do you see the nightmare that we're in? This is why we need to educate. our prospects. We need to educate the entire world on what IPM is, what holistic pest management is, where we take a holistic view of the entire situation. We have to deal with all the psychological issues. We have to deal with all the financial issues. We have to sell on the idea. All of the pressure that is on us, and we're like throwing up our hands and says, we can't do anything with these guys. Then nobody will listen. And then you've got five members on the board. Here's the problem. You need to do an extra service, like a $600 service. Now they need to wait until they have a board meeting next month. And meanwhile, the pest is multiplying by 6x every day that they wait to solve this problem. Then they need to all get together and vote on it. And one guy says, no, I'm going to bring in my buddy. He's going to solve this because he does my pest control at my apartment. And that guy just sprays everything and makes it worse. This is the problem that we're having, folks. So I'm on my way now to go see why. This is when I get involved. After my guys tried two times and we're still getting the same results, I have to get involved. I got to be a snoop now and spend the time in that unit and then spend the time with my tech, because I'm paying him by the hour. I don't pay him by production. Why? For this exact reason. When something needs to be done, he needs to be able to spend whatever time he has to spend doing the work so that we can satisfy, so we can solve the problem for this client. This is why I don't pay my people production when I'm paying him 15% and he's already been there an hour and I only charged $125 for an hour. You know, he's only made so much if he's making 18 to 20%. If I pay him by the hour, it's no skin off his back. It's my problem. And I have to go handle it. And I have to go deal with it. And I got to figure out why this is happening, because I am the technical director for my company. I'm the guy who designs the protocols. And if the protocol fails, we have to figure out why the protocol, because it works 95% of the time. This is the exception. So now, once or twice a week, I got to go deal with these issues. I got to spend 2 to 3 hours. This is far away. This is in probably 30, 40 minutes from here. Probably so. This is going to take me 3 hours of my day to try to figure out what this problem is. Probably go back in another week and figure this out if we're not figuring it out. Because we need to figure out now where the point source is. Where is it? Could it be downstairs? And the people downstairs are having the problem, and the worms are crawling up inside the wall, and they figure out an opening. How are we going to drill through marble to get it behind the wall? How are we going to, if the problem is behind the wall, do we have to tear a wall open? Now they got to get a contractor because there's probably a water leak behind that wall. We don't know. We don't know what we're running into. We don't know these situations. This is where my experience in construction comes in, where I can think this through and say, there has to be where the biology of the pest, they need water, they need humidity. Where's the water coming from? Is the board behind the tile leaking into the wall? Because is it the pan from the shower pan that was poured wrong? Is it, you know, I've had an issue with flies that were coming in, and it's because they forgot to put a U-trap when underground when they installed the hot tub. And there was never a U-trap in the hot tub. And they had to dig up the floor because there was a problem in the floor because the contractor made a mistake. These are issues that we have to deal with as pest control professionals, that everybody thinks that we do this for a living because we couldn't do anything else in life. That we just do is spray. Everybody sprays the same thing. What does it matter who you hire? It matters. Experience matters. Expertise matters. I have the experience and the expertise because I've been dealing with construction my whole life, with home remodeling. I've sold it. I've seen all the contractor problems. I know how that building is put together. And now I understand how that insect behaves and what that insect needs to survive. Now we got to go figure this thing out. So I'm going to show you some video of that, of where those things are coming from. See what you guys come up with. But understand, these are the challenges we have, folks, every single day of our lives. This is Frank the Pest Geek, wishing you a pestacular day.